Now, continuing with our Batman games, I think this might actually be one that was ported from NES, unlike the last one, which just looked like it was. Yeah, I think it's this one. Batman Revenge of the Joker. Was this originally a Nintendo game, an NES game, that was ported to Mega Drive? I'm told quite badly. Although it is the same people who did the Batman movie license game. Oh no, well, the same publishers, I'm guessing. They always do that thing with the bat, don't they? Let's just do a new game. This looks a little bit rough around the edges, as in probably early in the life of the Mega Drive. Yeah, some nasty animation going on there. Nasty cape animation. Don't like the look of it. I remember this being a shooter. I think I played this before. I remember this being a shooter. Essentially a platform shooter. And not a very fair one. See what I mean? I mean, what the hell? What the actual hell? Really? Yeah, I should have seen that coming, really. Enough said, I think. Expect more of that. I know you're going to come to life and kill me. I played you before. Yeah, not a patch on the other Sunsoft Batman game. Wow. And not a patch on the other Sunsoft Batman game. Back to the beginning. Hang on, you went there before. Maybe you were and I just didn't see you. Did he even come alive and kill you? Or did you just get stuff out of them? Have I just always been suspicious of them because of their little glowing eyes? Really, dude? Go. Oh, come on. They were not evenly spaced. Not that I'm whinging. I'm not really that bothered. Honest, I don't care. Right. But we can do better than this. But see where the colours kind of feel a bit 8-bit, don't they? Everything feels a bit... Oh, no. I was trying to avoid that knife and I just jumped straight into it. Everything feels a bit 8-bit. Like, you know, the palette doesn't have that 16-bit mentality to it, you know? There's no, like, overall kind of scene colours. We've got, like, a bright purple wall and that background wall, which is a nice... It works because it separates the background from the foreground. You can see what you can stand on and what you can't. But it does it in a way that the 8-bit games would, especially like Spectrum games, you know, where they'd use a different colour in the background. Oh, he's alive. He's alive and hurting me. Ow. Oh, really? Is that level 1.1? Like, as in, right at the beginning? Nobody likes that. I'm going to let that gargoyle live because I don't think they even... I don't know what these mean. Oh, no. I'm messing about deciding which to have. And I lost them all. There's a life lesson right there. What have I got? Oh yeah, hit by that. That's what I've got. Oh come on, it's just so cheap. Okay, I'm not even going to hurt him. I think that gargoyle has got a right to live like the rest of us. Let's have him. Yes. I'm not sure these guys have got a right to live. They're actually trying to kill me. Oh, that's a hurt. Did that gargoyle just hurt me? Just for touching it. I like the way that gargoyle's drawn, actually. They're pretty. Much better than Batman. And the music's not really Batman, is it? Oh, it's, you know what? This probably predates the Batman movie. Let's bear that in mind. So, up to the point where they made the Batman movie. I'm not sure what's going on with that guy. Up to... when they made the Batman movie, remember Batman had this kind of camp association with the 60s TV show. That was the last time he was on the screen, essentially, before the movie came out. So, you know, this game's actually done pretty well to keep him credible. Alright, just gotta get right up to them. Oh, not that close. Come on, let's do it. 1.1! Right, we're going to do a bit better this time. It feels a bit like a Spectrum game. It feels like an NES game again, which I'm told it is. I'm told this is basically an almost direct port of an NES game. It's been a total redraw, of course, but with the same mentality where, you know, the palette's just a bit garish. It's an early Mega Drive game. Possibly the first Batman game on the Mega Drive. It was never considered a classic. And apparently the NES version is much better, and I imagine it is, considering what the NES could do. I don't think this pushes the Mega Drive. It barely would Well, it would push an NES. It would push an NES, this game, but not a Mega Drive. That said, it's not a bad game once you start to get to know how the controls work. As you can see, I'm vastly improving at it. Well, he says that, and then he starts leaping about mindlessly. I don't like the animations. I don't like that design of Batsuit. Don't get me wrong, I know people who do. I know like comic artists who love that design of Batsuit, the blue and grey thing. It's not my, not my favourite. But I like him in the black. I like it to be a bit more realistic. The whole Chris Nolan thing kind of broke it open, really. Whoa. Ah, yes. This. Oh. Oh, that's awful. Collision detection. Not sure exactly where it is. I think... Oh. That was just bad collision detection. So the whole cape area is completely... completely safe from contact, which is fair enough. But it's like a big box collision at the front of him, which seems to stick out from his head. Oh. Ouch. And, maybe doesn't work for him. I don't like that jump animation either. I think his legs look a bit flimsy and rubbish. It all just feels a bit, you know. It's more in design, don't get me wrong, in design it's more like the Amiga Spectrum versions I was singing the praises of earlier in the earlier video. Oh, that is a pain. Oh, no more then. Jesus Lord. Come on, come on. Oh, don't die. Oh! I have no idea how you get past those. Oh, we'll give it another crack, eh? I must be doing something wrong. There must be a weapon of some sort. It always gets me. There must be a weapon here somewhere that you've got to use to get past them. It's got to be. It's got to be. Oh, I don't like that. Big box collision in front of his nose. I'm not happy about that. I barely care, to be honest. But yeah, it's like the animations are a little bit... his physique seems to change when he walks and jumps. You know, it's like... don't get me wrong, it's hard to get that stuff consistent, but... this is an official Batman game. Should be getting that right. You know? The colour scheme's a bit too... a bit too harsh for me as well. What's that? He did something. Oh, hello. Some kind of shield that might come in useful against the great big gargoyles. Although I have just effectively changed weapon, I think. Let's see if I can do it still. Oh, there's something going on there. Oh, that's not working. I'm just not hitting them. Oh, really? I have so had enough of this. That was Batman Revenge of the Joker for the Mega Drive. I am told it is not the best version, and you know what? I believe it.